hang on. Before we're doing that, let me show you something.
Me and RJ and the kids was on a camp out in the mountains, and we had one of them U-Drive Marmy Jeep cars, which we'd rented from a fella by the name of Q Bosky for $30 a day. Buy your gas along the way, take a rapid split, and leave a pint of blood for a deposit. And he explained it all to us, how we were supposed to get to Telluride, which is 50 miles away by way of the regular highway. However, there was a shortcut, but unless we had drove the Black Bear Road before, we'd better be off to stay in bed sleep late. Pay no attention to the guitar there. Well, we took up off on the highway, and we come upon a sign that says, Black Bear Road, you don't have to be crazy to drive this road, but it helps. I says, RJ, this must be the shortcut road Kuboski's talking about. She didn't pay no mind, because she was making peanut butter sandwiches for the kids in the back seat, throwing rocks and drinking Kool-Aid and playing count the license plates. But they wasn't having too much fun accounting a license plate or cars, because there weren't no other cars. We went about a mile and a half, about 4 hours, busted off the right front fender, tore a hole in the oil panel and rocks big as a hall closet. Went over a bump, spilt the Kool-Aid, and Roy G. stuck his bolo knife right through the convertible top, and the dog threw up all over the back seat. Peanut butter don't agree with me, see. So we had to stop, take off the top, and air everything out, clean it up. The dog run off, and RJ says she felt her asthma coming on. I was sitting there wondering what to do when the entire scenic San Juan U-Drive Marmy Jeep car sank in the mud at 13,000 feet above sea level. Well, we shoveled it out and ate our lunch. The dog made a yellow hole in the snow, and Roy Jean got out his Instamatic and took a snapshot of it. Mary Elizabeth drew a picture of the road. It looked like a whole bunch of Z's and W's all strung together. And RJ took one look at it and said the only way that Jeep car is going down that road is over her dead body. And a rock slipped out from under the wheel, and the U-Drive Marmy Jeep car went right over the edge of a cliff. Doggone it, Roy Jean. How many times do I have to explain it to you? When I tell you to put a rock under the wheel, I mean rock. Now look at that, what you'd have to go bigger than grapefruit.
All right, here we go. We're on the bottom. And anyway, we're down on mine. There's my drum over there. Another little spot I'm baiting out. And this is where we're going to put this tree stand up, ladder stand. And basically, it's going to be on the tree right here. It's going to give the best shot where I can shoot straight towards the corn that way. And then also, I'm going to have a shot over here towards the barrel. And I don't know. Anyway, we're fixing to fill that one up with corn and get this shit done. You want to hold that?
No.
I'll hold it.
Huh?
Picking my nose.
There we go. Hang on. Yeah, because they'll give me the shot down there.
Yep.
And I'll be able to take a shot over that one.
Oh, a it's teamwork. You're gonna build something, make sure you have a left-handed hammer.
No. We're the ambidextrous on the club.
Yeah. There we go, we got it up on the tree. And like I said, we got it pretty sturdy. This is how we done it. This one, if you're gonna be moving it around more often, we got the 2x4. You wanna hold that for a second? Yeah, get a better picture. I got mine because I'm not gonna be moving mine around, but it's if you're gonna be moving it around, you just go to, instead of running one load strap, go with three. Take one here, take one about midway down, and one down like that, and just move your load straps. Like I said, I mean, it's cheap. You sit there and pop it around, like if the wind changes direction, if, like say the wind's coming from this way today, we're good. And say tomorrow the wind's coming from that way, you can sit there, if it's portable, you can move it, to another tree, where you're downwind, and you sit there and you don't have to sit there and buy half a dozen bow stands or go out and pay $200-$300 when you can sit there and build one of these for less than $30. And that's what it's about right there, is saving money. And well, we're gonna go ahead and fill up a barrel and set up some other stuff down here, and I guess we'll see y'all here in a minute. Well, give me another clip.
Yeah, like I said, we got the little tree stand set up. It's probably, what is that, about 25, 30 yards?
Yeah.
About 30 yards away from here. This is going to be the primary because it's always going to have corn coming out. But eventually I'm going to put panels around here. I got a little setup I'm going to do. We're going to get it done and show you how to rig a little open-ended trap, or a catch. It's going to be where the hogs can come and go free when you're not hunting. Then when you're out hunting, there's a way you can sit there and close it up on them. But, yeah, this is it. We're fixed to go put up the other one on that gravel. And I guess, see you all when we get over there. You go. Here we are. We're on the gravel spot.
Hang on just a second. Somebody got hung up.
Yeah, that's what I was fixing to say. We got a minute to take a break now because our supply trailer, supply wagon, is hung up. One of the issues in the battle against keeping properly supplied logistics. I guess we're going to have to put a truck driver on it next time to make sure it gets there.
See if it gets hung up here? Alright, he's good.
Yeah, it's a gravel spot. Again, we're about 75 yards out from the stand. I went and set another tree stand up. You can see the high quality craftsmanship of that one. Built that one by myself. But now we're going to put that feeder up here. It's going to be a lick bucket style. And we're going to put panels around it. And build a little hole for the hogs to come in. And I figure, for a night spotlight and stuff, this will give me the closest often because I got the hogs are coming in here and I got a little spot right over there where I'm baiting. If you see further back, it's my regular feeder. But I still got some more plans out here. We're gonna put another food plot across the creek and then another time feeder over there. I'm even gonna try to figure out a way to get water down here. Yeah, I mean, I've never heard people ever trying to put water troughs off. You know, if you're out for the
works in Africa.
If you're sitting there, if you're 400 or 500 yards away from the nearest water, then that's the best thing to go. But here we go. We're gonna get him to. Yeah. Well, here we go. We're gonna sit that up. I can't remember where we go. We had a little technical difficulty, but I guess we'll get it up and then give y'all a little explain through it and everything what we're doing on it. But, yeah, we're gonna get this shit done.
About getting it up and there's none of the guys.
Only you would think about
that. We are gonna erect this deer feeder.
My feet. Believe me, hunting club.
You're on.